How you all doing? And welcome on in. I am the Ginger Beard Man, and we got a lot to talk about for Dead by Daylight, your weekly update. I'm going to go through the normal spiel I do on here, and then we're going to talk about everything and anything, and I literally mean that. We are going to be talking about updates, things going on, the kill switches, all that stuff, things coming soon, just a lot. So don't forget your free gift. As a normal, you're 200k there, and also if you want more blood points, you know, because people just love more blood points, you can put that code in and get 300k blood points right now too as we speak. So if you'd like to do that, you might want to get her done before they take it on off and then you can't get it no more. But on to other news. Right now, still, the Twitch drops are rolling. If you want to watch your favorite streamer, you know, for 6 hours, you can get all of those full cause medics right there. Goes till July 16th till the 30th, then you can have yourself your whole entire suit right there. And, yeah, I'm going to keep trucking. We're going to keep going because there's a lot to talk about. So I'm just going to keep rolling on. Cross progression is rolling. The only thing that is not rolling is on the Switch. It's not rolling everything, that's for sure. Shared paid currencies and shared DLC is not a thing on the Switch. So everything else is good and Gucci if you connect it all, but on the Switch, it does not roll like that. Speaking of all that good stuff right here that you see, if you have double paid DLCs, say I have one on Steam and I got the same one bought on Xbox, you will be getting 4,500 iridescent shards for every single one of those that you own double of. But there's a kicker. You know, nobody likes that kicker. You ain't going to get it until October 22nd. So you're going to have to wait all the way till then before you ever get to see it. So you got some time on your hands before you ever do see it. But cross progression is out and slowly running right now. I mean, there's kinks still in it. Don't get me wrong. That's, you know, every single update, but it is out, and but you won't be getting those 4,500 for each DLC until October 22nd. So yeah, you got some time on your hands, but that is it for that. Moving right along, the casting of Frank Stone. I will be playing through this whole entire thing here on the channel because I am a super massive games fan. I own probably every single one of their games, I believe I do. So yeah, I will be getting it and playing through it. It comes out September 3rd. If you'd like to get it, I could tell you right now, I will advocate for this. I have never been disappointed any super massive games that I have ever bought in my life. I've never been disappointed. They always have great stories. It's always really good because they do, you know, horror. So it's just really good. And I guarantee that the casting of Frank Stone is going to have a great story, multiple replayability. I just know it. It's going to have multiple endings because you're the one that's choosing who lives and who dies. Yeah. I don't really have to go any more than that. It just has a lot of replayability. So definitely you might want to look into that if you haven't already. There's tons of videos on it, tons of pictures, tons of everything. I definitely think it is going to be worth it. And like I said, I will be doing it here on my channel, doing a complete playthrough of it. And it will be in the Supermassive Games category with the rest of them that's already on here from Supermassive Games on my channel. So yeah, that tells you how much I already play Supermassive Games. But we're going to keep trucking on still. We're still going to keep trucking on. The 2v8 is coming in like days, the 25th. 25th, it will be coming. Right there is your 5-map pool of what you're going to be running on. You only need to get 8 generators fixed out of 13. There'll be no hooks. You're literally just knocking them down and putting them up on a like a cage kind of thing. Something like a Pyramid Head. I guess you could, you know, put it. So I think it's going to be fun. I do think it may be a little hectic. But after two of those cage stage, survivors can heal themselves. And there's 20 chests, you know, scattered about. And then they all have their own little classes, the survivors do. So it's going to be interesting, I think. It'll be an interesting time. I hope that the maps are not too small. Because, you know, that's a lot of people. So one could pray that they made them big enough. One could pray. Also on the 25th, Blood and Bones, the cosmetics come out for that. On the same day as the 2v8. So be looking for those cosmetics to pop up in the store. Let's head on over now. Getting to, it doesn't matter where we're going here. And see the old Shrine of the Week. What we normally do on here in the beginning, but, you know, since I got a lot to talk about, I'm kind of all over the place. But we are going to talk about the old Shrine of the Week. And then we're going to get on to that kill switch stuff. This week, Chlorophobia from the old clown, Dark Devotion from the plague, Empathy from the old Claudette, and Up the Ante from Ace, the gambling man. Out of all these, I'd probably say the one that's used the most is probably the one on the left, old Chlorophobia from the clown. So, if you were going to pick one out of here, that would be the one right here. If you're a killer main. If you're a survivor person, you're probably... Oh man, that's going to be a hard pick if you're going survivor. Up the Ante is good just for chest things, to get better chest items. Eesh. I'm probably going to have to go Claudette. Because I'm not a big chest person. So, yeah. I'll go with Claudette. So, let's talk about the kill switch. I know. You're saying, oh, God, not the kill switch, Gingerbeard Man. Please tell me that you got some good news. Well, I guess fixing it would be the only good news. Kill switch disabled. We have temporarily disabled the Blackwater Swamp Realm due to a bug which caused survivors to be unreachable. It will be re-enabled when the issue is fixed in the next update. One of the new Ormond map variations is disabled until the next hotfix. This I'm just not sure about right now. I don't know if they mean the Blackwater Swamp is going to be updated in tomorrow. Yes, tomorrow. Tomorrow. Tomorrow's first hotfix is coming out tomorrow. I don't know if they mean that or they mean a big update. I'm not sure what when's the swamp coming back. I don't know. I would think the one on the bottom, the Ormond map variation, it says the next hotfix. So that's number one, right? So, well, that's tomorrow. So I believe Ormond is coming back tomorrow. I don't think the swamp is coming back tomorrow. But here is the little bit of known issues. Issues with players not correctly receiving the endurance status effect. Fixed in hotfix 1. Generator count reduced when a survivor leaves the tally screen while this trial is going on. Tentative target for fix, hotfix 1. Those two right there are for tomorrow. Those are being fixed tomorrow. The ones that we don't know when they're going to be fixed and still waiting for a date. It's now on. Survivors remaining in floating animation after being grabbed by the Mastermind's Verlant Bound. Fixed in Hotfix 2, a Deep Rift cosmetic. Yes, some of your cosmetics are broke if you haven't noticed. Well, that's in Hotfix 2. BFX issues with Yui's Rift cosmetic is under investigation. Literally, I just said that their cosmetics are broke. Issue with survivors being unreachable in the Blackwater Swamp is... And like I said, kill switched until fixed. Oh, there it says fixed in hotfix 1. So we are getting the swamp back in hotfix 1. So we should be getting both these maps up here in hotfix 1. Should. Known issues that are marked with the targeted date fixed are not guaranteed. I literally just said should be fixed, and here we go. Well, they're not guaranteed. Oh, man. Anyway, that is that is all. That is it. That is all I have for you guys. Holy crap. Hopefully we get that out. But I hope you guys have fun on that 2v8. We'll see how all that rolls out and all that good stuff. And yeah, if you're not subscribed, please subscribe. I greatly appreciate it. Hit the bell so you know whenever other videos come out here on the channel, because I do this weekly. And like I said, the casting of Frank Stone is coming sooner or later here. And yeah, I do a lot of horror games. Let me know down below what you like about what's coming out, what's happening, what's going on, what you don't like. Please voice your grievances down below. I'd like to hear it, because I grievance about it all the time. So yeah, you guys all have a good rest of your day, and I'm out of here.